motorcycle is whatever you want to make it. Turn it on, you can give yourself a real thrill.
What's going on, guys? This is Carl with the RacerRed channel. Put a 12 tooth countertop sprocket on this bike, new front brakes, adjusted the rear brake. So we're testing it out today. And hopefully it works good for me. Down first gear. Now it's working really good for me up here. I really like first gear now. It's making me feel very comfortable with the speed I'm going. And I tested the top speed with this 12 tooth countershaft. And it's definitely quick still. This bike revs to the moon, but it'll still do well into the 70 mile an hour range. It'll do about 75 or 80, somewhere in there. Yeah, this bike is much better behaved now for the single track type riding. Much more manageable. Second gear feels like first gear used to. Yeah, it's working really good. interesting for me, the exciting thing is riding the bike and the terrain that I'm immersed in, the scenery and, you know, the landscape stuff that I'm riding through. But I've realized that for viewers, it's more about what you're saying, because a viewer can go anywhere online and see beautiful landscapes like this. But the viewer tends to, and this is true for me too, when I'm watching stuff, you don't really care so much about the scenery. A lot of the time. And that's, it definitely does play a part. You definitely want to see some cool scenery, but I would say for the most part, the rider is way more important, and what they are talking about is a lot more important than, you know, what they're riding through. Switchbacks up here are pretty tight. But this is one of the harder trails in this area, so I wanted to take the 450 on it and see how it does. Definitely doing well. When I make a bunch of changes to the bike, I like to make sure that all the bolts are staying put as well. And I stopped before I hit this trail and checked all the bolts, made sure they were good to go. The countershaft sprocket on this is held in with a bolt, so you gotta make sure that that's not starting to work its way loose. But I have adjusted this rear brake downward a little bit, and it could even go down a little bit further, but at least it's to the point now where I don't have to constantly think about it. Because before, I would hit that rear brake, before I could even pull the clutch in, and it would kill the bike. Because the rear brake was just, it would come on instantly. So, I don't know if you guys can hear it, but I can utilize a lot more of this engine now, so it's much better. I can utilize way more of it out here on the single track. It's much better behaved. And it's got a top speed that's well... It's definitely worthy of trail riding and even desert racing. So I don't think I'll need to go above 70 too often. I wanted to turn on the other camera so that I can get some good B-roll, and also every once in a while I think I'm going to start posting just a music overlay video where you can just watch it and enjoy some relaxing music or something and have the engine noise audible as well. This stuff definitely wears you out. I feel like I'm conserving energy, but I'm getting winded. Both of these tires are hooking me up. Me some safe passage so far. Hopefully this continues. About a four-stroke is it really has so much torque that it's way more tiring than a two-stroke. If you let out the clutch, you're getting a lot of force put on your arms. So it's definitely a little bit more tiring, I guess. And I could just be a little bit out of shape for this kind of riding too, since in the winter time I'm pretty much stuck in the desert areas. That tree could knock somebody over, so I'm gonna take care of that. Well, this is about as far as I go without messing up the trail, guys. So, catch you on the way down. Peace.